More than 50,000 people will die of colorectal cancer in the United States alone this year. And this figure includes people younger than age 50. I'm Dr. Lidia Schapira, and I'm a medical oncologist and professor of medicine at Stanford University. Today we'll be focusing on colorectal cancer. In this video, I'll touch on a few key points. Colorectal cancer develops in the cells which line the colon or the rectum. Cancers form when cells begin to grow out of control and form a mass that we call a tumor. Some tumors grow but stay in place and we call them benign, but others have the ability to grow and spread to other parts of the body, and these we call cancerous. Sometimes benign tumors can become cancerous over time. You may have heard that colorectal cancer often begins as a polyp, and doctors can visualize and remove them when they are at this very early stage during a procedure called colonoscopy. If they are left in place, we run the risk that these polyps can grow into cancers. So finding and removing polyps can prevent colon cancer. I want to show you the typical progression of colon and rectal cancer to better illustrate how this can happen. Now, the first step toward colorectal cancer is moving from normal tissue shown here toward what's called hyperproliferative growth. This just means that instead of growing as a nice flat line to cover the colon or rectum, cells begin to multiply at an increased rate and grow on top of one another. The abnormal cell growth usually happens because of a mutation to their DNA, something that can happen as the cells go through normal division. If this growth continues, then these cells form a polyp. At this point, the polyp would still be benign, but with more irregular growth, the polyp may begin to take on more mutations and display increasingly irregular growth. With enough irregular growth and mutations, the growing polyps may reach the point where they're cancerous, with their growth becoming unchecked and them having the ability to spread cancer to other parts of the body. As you can see, this is a sequential process, with early irregular growth leading to the formation of polyps and eventually even cancer. This progression from slightly abnormal to frankly cancerous takes years, even decades. For most of us, these polyps don't begin to form until we're 30 to 50 years old, and it may take another 10 to 20 years for them to become malignant. This gives us doctors a window of opportunity to look inside the colon, to look for abnormal areas such as polyps and remove any that look suspicious. The tissue is then analyzed in the pathology lab, and appropriate recommendations are made to the individual person. This is why we recommend screening for colorectal cancer. When it comes to screening, colonoscopy is the gold standard. During the procedure, the specialist places a thin, lighted tube with a camera on top and threads it up through the rectum into the colon while you are comfortably sedated and have been given pain medication. Placing this camera allows the doctor to look inside the entire rectum and colon in looking for polyps or cancer and also to remove them. This makes colonoscopy a great tool for both screening and disease prevention. The first step in deciding when to begin screening is to talk with your primary care doctor about your age and your risk factors. People with an average risk should begin screening at age 45, but this may need to be even sooner for people with significant risk factors. One of the most important risk factors for colorectal cancer is age, since the majority of colorectal cancers occur in people older than 50. The average age for men diagnosed with colon cancer is 68, while for women it is 72. It is important to realize that some people may be at increased risk, and that is why we recommend reviewing your risk factors with your physician. For example, Black Americans have the highest rates of non-hereditary colorectal cancer in the United States. Risk for developing colorectal cancer is also influenced by your family history. This is especially true if members of your family were diagnosed with colorectal cancer before the age of 60. It is helpful to know your family history and review it with your physician to help determine when you should start screening. There are also other options for colon cancer screening, which you can discuss with your doctor. From testing a stool sample to see if there's blood present, or detecting the DNA of cancer cells, to using other imaging strategies to visualize the colon and rectum, there are ways to customize screening to meet everybody's needs. Computed tomography scans or CT scans of the colon can be an alternative for people who cannot have a standard colonoscopy due to the risk of anesthesia, that is the medication that blocks pain during the procedure. Sigmoidoscopy is very similar to colonoscopy, except only the lower portion of the colon is seen because it is a more limited procedure. Other options for screening include fecal immunochemical testing. These tests are quickly evolving and have been found to detect cancer cells in stool at early stages. So in summary, in this video we discussed how colon cancer progresses from the irregular growth of cells in the colon or rectum, what risk factors might make someone more likely to experience this kind of abnormal growth earlier in life, and how we can protect ourselves against this kind of cancer through the regular use of screening tools like the colonoscopy. As always, reach out to your doctor if you have any symptoms or additional questions.